Alright, hello buddy, it is Lucky again, and we are back with yet another Savage match, DeMo versus DA, week 3. We've got DeMo on the human side, DA playing beast side, huge amount of players, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 versus 10. And actually both teams brought like one player who has 250 ping, crazy. With that said, we've got two power mining garrison and power mining subler. And right off the start, we've got a lot of scouts going all over the map. Not a big surprise since there are so many players. And Raju is gonna try to defend his position against two scavengers, but he's gonna get sandwiched. He let Techno get behind him and he did not block. So those two scavengers are gonna enter the human base, no problem. Or are they? Already two guys approaching them. That's a wise choice since there is no guard tower. Actually, the guard tower is right now up. Oh, Techno getting another kill there on Moxy. But looks like that's the end of the beast adventure in human base for now. That buys actually some space for Anti to get close, and Anti gets kill on Worker. Now he's buying a lot of time. Actually, a whole DeMo team spawning to kill them. So much time lost in power mining. With that said, we've got this base layout that we have seen from Warrior, I think. Yeah, that was Warrior. But with a slightly better tech position, we already see this arsenal blocks this path from behind of a stronghold. There is your shield. And what's worth saying is that human went for Alec first, so they will need to show their flux abilities if the sack waves come. And speaking of Sackwave, yeah, I forgot to report, there is the Subler going up on south. But let's check the beast tech. They went for Strata, so completely classic. And also classic the battle, he's just spamming those workers and his team all over the map. He wants to get those Sublers up very quickly, and that's really good for his team, because it's definitely easier to just defend your Subler rather than try to get position and build a Subler. With that said, we've got a whole bunch of human, not even with flux, just discharges. They're coming towards the Subler. I will follow them in a moment. Let's check out what's gonna happen here. We've got Siege Workshop and Magnetic almost up. Magnetic up right now, so the shield will be on the way. And yeah, Tempest versus discharges. What you gonna do? Actually, you're gonna hit the clutch shots, I guess. But looks like these are falling back. They do not want to get in range of those discharges. They get a couple kills here, and looks like it's gonna be cleaned. One more Nomad, and ooh, nice meter shot by Lion. Wow, this Lion loves to talk a lot. Whatever. And yeah, I really like those Sublers from Battle. He gets this one, which kind of allows him to control North and Middle more or less. With Sucks, he can easily get there and suck down any garrison attempt. And he gets this South one, which allows him to control the human second mine. So right now it's all on human. They have better tech since they did not go for two Sublers, or two garrisons rather, all over the map. Their tech is slightly advantageous right now. They need to push in. They need to get some space for garrisons to be built. Otherwise they will be close in their base with no redstone to work with. What is this? KraKen actually deciding to go for Frostbolt rather than Tempest, and that's because he has 250 ping. So aiming might be slightly difficult when you have such high ping. It looks like DeMo actually doing good job of clearing all those stalkers. They still have 20,000 gold saved up in bank. And ooh, Stringer dies there.
Now you know the strength of the horde.
Oh, let's check out the human base. Like, quite nice and cheap layout. Obviously, extremely vulnerable to summoners, but you can always turtle it. And looks like we can't check the beast base because the battle spawns and power mines with his team. They are getting a charm shrine, which is up right now. So no level 3 on the way, and I imagine human will have legionnaires much sooner than predators on the beast side. And look at that! Human actually managed to get close to the Saddler. There was no spawn, no defense earlier on. That could be so bad. This Saddler is right now in a horrible spot. They're even getting some kills all over the map. There is finally a spawn wave, but the damage is already being dealt. Alec power up even being used. The Saddler is going down. If you're going for Tempest, you can't allow them to get so close to your Saddler. It's just so hard to defend. You need to get some cheap damage beforehand. Will they take down the Saddler or will it last? It will last on barely any HP. But it will. So that's actually very, very good for Beast. That could be so much worse. The Saddler goes down, it immediately opens this mine, or actually even the south mine, since you just, the beasts do not have middle Saddler, so it's quite a long way for them to go. If human manage to just stand on this hill and flags down everybody who comes there, it's just too hard to push currently. And lovely maneuver from DeMo right now. They're pushing as whole group, and again DA did not respond in time. They did not set their defenses on this line. They did not get some Tempest damage and another power ups wave. This is definitely gonna be harmful. At least they have a Spire now, which is so good in defense. But will it matter? I don't know. It's so chaotic right now, but looks like the Frostbolts, oh boy, for the moment it looked like it's gonna allow them to clear, and it will. I mean, I don't know, if human had one ballista sitting up this hill, this Saddler would be probably down. I mean, I don't say that necessarily the ballista would kill it. He would get probably like 2-3 shots and then he would be killed by a Tempest. But that means couple of players have to go and kill this ballista with Tempest while your savages are actually working on a Saddler. Would probably be enough. And holy shit, we've got a bold move from human commander. He's sending 6 workers towards the middle. I have no idea. Yeah, it's definitely human already scouted the Saddler out, so they know it's there, but they still are gonna go for a sneak. It's all up to K now. He has to kill this stalker. You cannot let him scout out your workers. But Anti, he has no idea that is going on, but I'm gonna leave them being, because looks like DeMo found their way again, and this time with legionnaires. That has to be GG for this Saddler. I mean, there are at least 3 spires, and it doesn't look like human have DeMos. Yeah, and Alec power up is being wasted on a guy who dies immediately. But that's enough time and space for 3 spires to go down, and still there are some legionnaires up. Well, right now it's so good for Beast to defend just with Frostbolts. Frostbolts are amazing on legionnaires. They still hold it. Looks like those workers died or they stopped here. Let's check out, are they all here still? Yes, they are all here, but oh boy, it looks like they cannot get through. You can't order your workers to go through this tunnel. Oh, that's bad. Unless they just want the garrison here and they want... Oh crap, I got stuck. Sorry. Let's see... No! He was just waiting for his scout to go through. That's huge. Actually, DeMo right now, they're applying pressure from both sides. Not a huge pressure on North Saddler. Just like 2 legionnaires. but it's enough to keep Beast distracted. Looks like Raju this time wasn't synchronized with his team. And there we go, a middle garrison, a bold move, but a move necessary for human. If they pull it through, if they get to mine here, that's gonna be like amazing for them. Straight away they go for mining. They have actually redstone. They have no redstone at all saved up. If that got scouted out and killed, that would be probably game for DA, or at least like 20 minutes of freedom where they wouldn't have to worry about any garrisons, anything, just distant mining. Look at this fire ward spam. This one disruptor would be so huge. Do they have a disruptor? No, doesn't look so. They're actually opting to go with ammo pack. Well, I imagine Beasts are right now like, holy crap, how did they get behind the Sabler? And the Sabler speaking of will go down. Finally we have Predator's KraKen. What you doing? He's just gonna die. I guess it was a lag since he's a guy with 250 ping. But right now the tides have turned and DeMo taking down both of those four Sabblers. This is so bad right now for Beast. They are stuck in their own base. Do they even have resources? Let's see. No, they are completely out of resources. They need their second mine. This is so bad when you're a commander. Suddenly you lose two Sabblers and you lose all your income of redstones. Where did I lose this team fight? Oh. And there is another wave of legionnaires coming towards the Beast base. Oh, a solo predator, that's not gonna be good. You're just gonna feed them more gold and eventually it's gonna mean less defenders in the base, but will it even matter? There is nobody spawning. Fire is being damaged. Where is DA? Now they're spawning. Three predators versus four legionnaires. It looks like actually, yeah, very nice defense from DA in the end, but still damage done. Fire is almost done. One more wave like this and they will lose it, and they really cannot afford it. And oh boy, a ballista of doom is coming. Oh, but it gets scouted out actually in time, but Anti has to fall back. He cannot stay. He can't fight this ballista. The ballista is already in range, I believe, for this fire shrine, and yes it is. The fire is gonna go down. KraKen is not gonna be enough. He gets immobilized, he gets a heal, but that's not enough. Two legionnaires working on him. This game from really, really good situation for Beasts. They just couldn't hold it, and this middle garrison took them by surprise. Oh man, that's so costly. It's actually game costly for Beasts. If they scouted it out, they would definitely, well, I guess they would win it. They would take the control over the map, maybe tie it, but I don't know. They could get Sabblers all over the map, get all resources, slowly siege the human base. But it's all the past now. They did not scout it, and well, right now the Arcana is being taken down. No, actually the shots are too high, slightly too high. Two ballistas, three, but four ballistas. Oh man, and there is not enough response from Beast. They have Blaze. Why are you not coming with Blaze, Lion? Those ballistas are not very vulnerable to Tempest. They're gonna go down eventually. The lair is under siege. It's so low. Even the battle gets a beautiful Freeman sacrifice there on those ballistas. I guess to kill a legionnaire there as well. Yeah. But that's not enough. More ballistas are coming. The response sack wave actually could be enough. And looks like it. Techno almost making it to this garrison, but that's just too hard. DeMo is just camping them, just fluxing them down on the way. not letting them get close, and with that they are gold starving them. Actually not that much, 27,000. They still get couple nice kills. They pick up the gold from ballistas, I guess. But the ballista is shooting again. Larry's so close to going down. Somebody and all workers are repairing it. Oh man, I think it's time for human to get another garrison on the north and finish Beast off with killing their second mine. Maybe they can just push through. Let's see. Finally, Legionnaires decide it's enough of holding back. You cannot defend your ballistas from sacks and blazes, not fast enough. You need to push through, you need to make Beast just take those tough choices. Do you want to kill Legionnaires or do you want to kill the ballista? There is no good choice in it. You really, really can't defend from those speed pushes. Defacer, he gets a leg, but that's not really effective. Anyways, that said, this lair is so close to going down. One ballista, and this is the one ballista that we need to kill. This lair, will he go down? Doesn't look so, no. Oh, DeMo is successfully defending him. Last shot flying. Oh, not last shot. There it is. Wow, this middle garrison cost DA the game, and we've got 1-0 for DeMo. Well, see you in the next round, guys. Alright guys, welcome back to round 2 of DeMo versus DA. We got DeMo on B side, DA on the human side now. Obviously 1-0 for DeMo after this sneaky garrison going up in middle saved them the game. We've got power mining subler for beasts, power mining garrison for human, two scouts from beasts, but they are scattered, and one is north, one is south, and the south one is gonna meet the double scout team from human. It's gonna be anti and techno. Let's see, can he get some damage done? He already ate one arrow, second arrow from techno there. Oh, the third one from anti, and techno finishes him off. So far no information given. Another scout actually immediately going out of the beast base. Looks like Shagroth is gonna enter the human base from north. Yeah, he's gonna get all the information they need. There is magnetic for him. Oh boy, he actually even gets one worker down. That's kind of huge. You could think like, oh, that's just one worker. That's actually effectively so much time. And look at this, anti and techno, they entered the beast base, and right now they're defending on this clutch point here. Oh boy. They get a lot of kills and a lot of time. Also, this one worker is meaningless compared to how much time they stole from beasts. And Strata is already up, so classic beast. We haven't seen anything different so far. I mean, maybe you have seen in different shortcuts. I haven't seen it. And for human, we've got this classic shield, which is gonna be probably placed here. Probably with a garrison there. Everything here, quite classic. And right off the start, we've got workers quickly going towards this south mine. That's huge. I guess the battle just saw how difficult it is once you get close with those sublers, and he just doesn't want this situation to happen to his team. He's just getting his garrison, and there it is. Meanwhile, we've got whole beast team coming towards middle. That's a bit shameful. They did not go south. That would probably cost human this garrison, as it's only defended by two nomads. But in return, they are gonna take the middle mine. They are gonna take this crucial position on the map. But with that said, it's gonna be on them to apply pressure to take down this garrison and limit the resource income that human can get from it. But I think it's not gonna happen. I think human, that was a correct move from human, and they're gonna get enough resistance from it. Unless, of course, they can somehow stand on a hill and Tempest workers down. That's gonna be so costly for human if that happens. Let's see. We got repeaters against Tempest. Wow! Anti-killing knows that. Not a good drop. Oh my god, what's going on in base? There is a whole bunch of scavengers pushing in. They're tempesting those savages. They are tempesting workers now. But so far only one worker died, and that's not very effective. Actually, they killed three now. This is a huge position from Shagroth, obviously. He kills so many workers. This is huge for beasts now. They got a lot of space created by that. And with that said, we got shield up, and let's have a closer look. Oh. What? Can you get here actually? Nah. Okay. Shield is safe. It's the battle took every step. He even put one tower there. He did not want to risk any possibility of sack there. So human right now scouted out the middle subler. I'm not sure. I don't think beasts have scouted the garrison. Probably they have, because they are coming in as a whole group right now, and that's a good time. The shield is not up yet. The towers are gonna go, are going up here. If they manage to kill it, there is the shield. Human just need to kill those stalkers before they can kill the shield, but it's so hard for stalkers to kill it. They will need to use those heals. They, oh, the clutch shots are amazing right now from DeMo. They defended their position, and shield is going down. That's gonna be costly. 1000 redstone taken just like this from human, and they, oh no, let me check how much redstone. They didn't even mine 1000 redstone. I mean, they mined 1000 redstone, a bit above 1000 redstone, so it's completely not worth it for them. I don't know how did that happen. This garrison was up for so long. Oh boy. And let's have a look. We haven't seen any progress in tech. Actually, yeah, they went fire rather than fast level 3. So they will try to suck this garrison down. They do not want human to get anything more than they already had. And really, I don't know. It seems like for some reason they did not utilize this garrison. It's still standing up, but it's really half HP, and there is a huge wave from Nemos. They do not play a classic WW style where they just split in two groups. They just go full in, and that's what they should do right now. The sack wave is there. They're completely actually unchallenged. These repeaters cannot do anything. If human had flux at least, they could kill one or two of those stalkers, but the repeaters, that's just not enough effective damage. And looks like human are just down to what they have in the base. Wow, I don't know. It was a correct choice, I guess. Oh, nice jump. This temp is actually giving him boost. But it was a correct choice to get this garrison early, but they just did not get the rest on from it. Oh, I got a bit lost there. But yeah, DeMo, they are really good at this camping your workers, killing them all the time. Seems like human already lost around 20 workers, maybe not that many, but still, that's so much redstones and so much time. All the beasts have to do now is just get tech and push into human base once they have the tech advantage. But they need to keep an eye on north. I mean, so far no human is there, but beasts have no idea what's going on there. As far as they know, there could be a garrison going up. Human actually forced to mine in the base just because those workers going down all the time. You think the one power here could be so big, just blocking some of those tempests. And again, DeMo, they're just going like one, maybe two guys to scout other directions, and then a whole team together, a full push in. And they don't even take a summoner with this push. They do not want to kill the shield. All they want to do is just apply pressure, kill workers, starve human a bit more, get some more time before human can get level up and legioness, and just wait for those predators, which I imagine is gonna go up soon. I think they have level already. Well, fire power up on Defacer not being useful there. He's gonna go down to the Savage, nice swing. And let's have a look at the Beast base. Yeah, level 3 is up, so... Oh, actually, Predator is going up right now. 70 seconds left. And human, they do not have level 3. They are getting Alec right now. They didn't even have Alec Factum. That's so bad for them. Oh, I don't know how it got so grim. I think it's just this fact that they lost so many workers that cost them so much time and so much resources as well. Oh boy, but even when they get this Alec, I don't think they have Redstone for level 3. So they're not even gonna have Coil. And Coil is crucial in defending from those summoners. Those long corridors here. Repeater is not gonna be very useful. And already looks like Beast managed to cage human inside their base. Moxy and Shagroth pushing from the other direction. If they kill those workers, can the A commander take it anymore? Yeah, he's just moving those workers away. Run, workers, run! Moxy actually opting to go for Ballista. So workers are gonna survive. And Alec is up. So I would love to check how much resources they have. They actually are so gold starved, and DeMo just sitting in front of them, just using Tempest to its tops, killing all those farmers. Oh, this is really, really huge for DeMo. The plays they are doing, currently they are winning the field by far. They do not let DA farm. And the redstone mine is actually running out right now, and who knows, getting two more workers down. Let's see, 785 redstones. So they're gonna get, oh, what I didn't think about, without Alec they had no repeaters. That's why they're gold starved like crazy. They cannot push any through, since they will lose all the time. Once you die, you lose gold. And boy, there is the Sabler. And can they do anything? I don't think so. They don't even have a garrison there to spawn close. Oh boy, this is bad. They have no way to take down the Sabler. Especially Savages versus Predators. Especially Savages with repeaters. No flux. They have at least they have relocators. Looks like Mercury actually left the game. Oh man, that's not good. There is a summoner. But he dies to tower and repeater fire. Shield is already being hit once. Another summoner from the other direction. Right now, that's a split from DeMo. They're gonna get this damage done on the shield. Only one spawner, but Defacer, he has no HP at all, but they did not focus him. They wanted the summoner so badly, and it actually cost him a shield. Oh boy. How did that happen? They had this early on garrison on south. I thought it's such a good position, but it wasn't enough. DeMo just completely outplaying DA on the field with those pushes. Very nice Tempest aim, and just killing workers so many times, and now it's just gonna be a slow death for DA. They lost all base defenses, and they don't even have gold for Savages. Actually, somebody has Moonlight, but it's not enough. Two Predators versus one Savage. More or less like two girls, one cup or something. Yeah, bad joke. In the end, I guess we've got a level 3 Stronghold for Human. And just to give you the example of how hurtful it was for DA not to have relocks, their final score is 29-67, while DeMo sits on comfortable 76-43. And it's gonna be a 2-0 for DeMo after what looked to be DA round in round 1. Well, it all got turned and DeMo takes a safe 2-0 victory. So guys, see you in the next Shoutcast, I guess.